Fortescue Metal Group and Rugby WA Premier Grade match between UWA and Perth Bayswater. My name's Jason Marrable. I'm joined by my colleague here, Dane Lazarus. Dane, let's chat rugby.
Mate, I'm looking forward to this. Does bring me back. Let's Chat was a famous show that Rugby WA ran. Shout out to Dave Berry, Graham Cooper.
So, Dane, it's knockout rugby. Doesn't get much better than this, does it? The winner's going through to the Grandy at Wanneroo next week. For the loser, the unlucky loser, their season ends. The two teams we've got here, we've got the minor premiers, UWA, very strong all season, top of the ladder. Perth Bayswater, they've been the, well, maybe not the surprise package, but I guess the people's team this season. How do you see this one playing out?
Yeah, the Numbats have toiled hard all season. Some very, very good victories all year against some top teams. And mate, they'll come out firing. They've got nothing to lose. The UW are the favourites for this game, so you know everything to play for UW, and they'll be wanting to win here at home.
Well, UWA have been here before last year. They made the semi-final against the eventual champions Cottesloe, losing at the death in that one, and a pretty epic semi-final. So they'll be looking to go one better here. Perth Bayswater, as you said, playing with house money, nothing to lose. Probably weren't expected to be in the finals at this stage, but they've had some amazing performances this season. Some real standout players and a couple of force players in there to top it up as well. So they've definitely got the flair players out there that can win them a game. It's just whether they can go the distance over 80 minutes.
Yeah, absolutely. Isaac Fiennes will be crucial here in this one. As you mentioned, the force players there dotting around the grades. But yeah, Isaac Fiennes will be key for Bayzy getting on the front foot.
So the hill here at UWA has been filling up all day nicely to my left. There's a fair few Numbats on it. I think the groundskeeper hasn't been keeping that in check, but it's filling up nicely. You can see from the skies here, grey skies. I can confirm it's dry. It's a dry track, and it's probably one of the best tracks in rugby at the moment, but it is windy.
It's freezing.
It's windy. The wind, I'm not sure if it really helps anyone because it's coming directly into our screens here from across the field, but it's going to affect the kicking in one direction, that's for sure. Pretty heavy wind. So the teams are just in the sheds at the moment and get ready to come out. Who are our referees for today's game, Dave?
We've got Sam? Sam Jones? Sam Jones is running around in the middle of this one. We've also got Graham Cooper.
Oh, it's not bad. Anytime you can call an international level referee to run AR for you, it's pretty handy, isn't it, Dave?
I'm pretty sure Coops has in his contract that he can only do stand games, so he'll be having a chat to his manager.
Very lucky here on the YouTube there to have him. As mentioned, there's another semi-final on today over at Bennett Park. That's going to be an absolute cracker. Their deck's not quite as nice as this one, but that is another do-or-die game between West Scarborough and Netherlands. You can tune into the stand commentary on that one. If you have their subscription, head on over.
I wouldn't go. I'd stay here.
Get the double screen, I reckon.
Stay here. Stay with us.
So a couple of other obviously important games taking place. It's been an absolute supercharged semi-final weekend here at UWA Sport Park with 8 senior grade games. We had the women's elimination final just before this game over on field. So cracking referees.
Superbly refed.
It's a big day for the referees as well as the teams come out. UWA just about to be heading down the hill, led out by Rory O'Sullivan running through first. Is it going to be Revenge of the Nerds? That's what we want to know today.
Students want to go one better here against the Numbats, and here they come. Jack Bromley leading them down. Captain for the UW team today.
They've got some experience, don't they, Dane? You've got players like Clay Ewan and Caleb Young. They've been here before. I mean, Caleb Young's, icing kicks to win grandies for another team. We won't talk about that, but he's for UWA now, and he'll be hoping to do that today. But they've got that big game experience, don't they?
Absolutely, they do. They got winners all over the park. Clay Ewan as well, ex-Western Force player, so he'll know how to win a few games, score a few tries. And we have the Perth Bayswater Rugby Club, the Numbats, heading on out onto the field.
Here they come. Bigotu leading them out. He's been a huge player for them this season, playing at number 12. Big unit, breaks the line, but he's got silky skin.
commentators are here. Graham, thanks, Graham. Thanks for the words of advice there. Graham Cooper just giving the commentary box just a few words of encouragement for the game.
As we said, with this wind, Dane, you could pop down to the kicking in this one. Who can navigate this wind? Your penalties and conversions are on the line. It could be coming down to those two kickers.
The other thing that could come into play, especially with this wind, is the 50-22. The wingers will have to hold their distance, and that will create some attacking opportunities for either back line, especially on this heel side.
And referee Sam blows the whistle, and we are underway here at UWA for the semi-final between these two teams. How good is it? Knockout rugby.
Okay, take him back!
The wind is going to be hard to play into, so yeah, the boys are going to have to narrow up a little bit on attack. And just an early knock on there by Bayswater, and here comes Victor Harris on attack for UW. Yeah, centre field here, strong attacking position.
So all the chat I've heard around the community is that UWA have the strongest scrum. Is that true, Dane, do you think?
You know what, Jace, I think having watched a few of their games that they may have the slight edge. Victor's a very, very strong scrummager. I've been lucky enough to coach him way back in under 15, junior gold, under 17 junior gold, and yeah, he's always been a strong scrummager at the loose head, so we'll see it here for the first scrum.
Well, it's a great position for UWA, just off to the right of the post. Lovely little setup, three to left, three to the right. That one goes down pretty quickly, so Sam says we'll have another crack at that. As I said, it is a dry track, it's absolutely wonderful, I can tell you, so no issues with the footing.
What a nice crowd here today, Jason.
Oh, how good is it to see this many people out watching community rugby?
Yeah, eight rugby games here at UWA Sports Park, McGilbray Oval, home of UWA. Really, really good day of rugby.
It's an early penalty to UWA there.
Yeah, Nyona just got caught there, loose head. Just have to double check that to make sure Yonah's in number one. Could be a few jersey changes.
So how often have we seen this season? Caleb Young lining it up for a kick. I'm hoping to get UWA. As you can see, that wind just absolutely burling in at the moment. So it'd be interesting to see. Probably be a pretty easy kick for him on a still day.
I think Caleb's a quality kicker. Should be an easy one for him. Commentator's curse, though. We'll see what happens. Commentator's curse.
Curse of the commentator, a curse of that wind, but that just goes to show how hard that's going to be to navigate today. And as I said, it could be a bit of a leveler for both teams, and I wonder how quickly they persevere and say, well, let's keep it through the hands.
Yeah, I hope coach of UWA Alex Dyker doesn't listen to his commentary. He'll definitely have a word to me after the game.
Otu from Perth Bayswater kicks it on.
Brendan Forster just misjuggled it there backwards. Aiden Shortall. Big up and under, and this is a good decision.
Ball's out.
Oh, he somehow gets that loose. Isaac finds it. Another good opportunity for UWA, but it's a little bit scrappy at the back.
Gone a bit long there by Rory O'Sullivan. Maybe keeping it in hand might have been a better option.
Just need to dial in the radar a little bit here. Early
So I think keeping the ball in hand, especially in this position of the field, UW go through phases and win the numbers. So I think, yeah, a bit of nerves is what's
going to happen. So you keep your height, okay, and support your weight through the legs, like we said.
Let's get dots. Stop here, boys. Stop here. You're not semi. Lock.
Crouch! Bind! Set!
Go! Go!
Victor Harris, I heard it earlier. Absolute dominant scrum there by Victor at the loose end for UWA. That's really, really strong work by him, and it's going to give UWA another chance. What do they do?
Lifted Sam about 3 feet off the ground. They're driving him back.
Yeah,
and just popped him up there. So, but interesting call here. They're going to go for the corner and see what their line out can do. Obviously, kicking's an issue, but throwing the straight ball is going to be a challenge today as well. Line out, 5 out. Great opportunity here for UWA.
What we got, boys? How many? That full.
To roll around left, this is looking good here. They got a little bit of momentum. Referee said it stopped once. Yona's actually come through and really well for Perth Bayswater there, but I think the six has come through being a bit naughty and the referee's put his arm out. UWA will have another penalty here.
Very scrappy at the base there for UW. They need to clean that up and secure their ball.
UWA looking to make an early statement here. Who's out there? They're over. First try of the game is coming after the line out and the penalty.
Can't quite see who scored that one, Jason. But
who comes up with it, I think.
I think there's a few claiming it, but great play there by UW. Finally settled it down at the back of the ruck. Got players in position and just started to work into the weak shoulder, scoring 15 metres infield there.
So I think it was Timothy Wallace who ended up that one. Just nice little 5 metre pass off the ruck. Had the support. Pretty simple stuff, but Perth Bayswater is going to be penalised both by the referee and the scoreline if they don't sort of sort that scrum out pretty quickly. That could be a problem for them all day.
Yeah, absolutely.
Just pillars there, Coop. Same thing.
So that try coming 7 minutes into the game.
Fond memories kicking from this position a couple of years ago.
A bit close to the sideline, wasn't it, Dane?
Well, I think it might be there.
It's just as good.
He's dialed it in now. It's a fantastic kick in the conditions. And UWA up 7-0 early. Perth Bayswater will want to see if they can play some footy down in UWA's territory after pretty much spending the first 8 minutes in camp in their own half. But early days here, they've got some great players. They just want to for the backs to have a bit of a run at any chance, because that's where probably a lot of their skilled players are. Big number 8 as well, who's pretty lethal if he gets out in the open.
Oh Nathan Hardwick, early doors, hitting back after the try, and there we have it. What a way to hit back.
Absolutely, fan. Who needs phases in rugby, mate? Just score one right off the kickoff. Well, was that the wind as well off the kickoff, Dane? Misjudged.
Yeah, misjudged there off the kickoff. Misjudged off the kickoff, and I think that try went to...
I think it was Sam George getting that one. It was both wingers... the winger, Liam Becker, got it, passed it inside to Sam George, who went over the line, and there's a UWA player down. A bit worse for wear as the numbats make a little bit of noise on the hill.
Yeah, I think... think Brendan Force is just down getting treated by the medical. That'll be a big loss if he goes off the field, so they'll have to get him back. I'm sure he'll be all right.
Well, if you're Perth Bayswater, you couldn't have hoped for a better
reply.
A better reply to that. It happens so often in rugby, isn't it? You concede a try, and then, or you score a try, and then you concede really quickly afterwards. And, yeah, great response from Perth Bayswater. Hopefully we get another 70 minutes of this. That'd be pretty good.
Tough kick here for Otu. Kicking into the teeth of the wind.
Right into the wind. Two supreme kickers here in this game. That you cannot get much harder of a kick than that, and just gives a lot of the nerds on the hill a bit of a wink as he runs by as well. UW80 get us underway. They go deep with this one. And Otu takes it and says, "We won't play it from there." Kicks it up. Jeez, into the wind as well. He's got a pretty good distance on that one. Graham Cooper says, actually, we'll do that at halfway.
Yeah, back on the line, yep.
Okay, to take the throw for you, WA.
Line out.
Straight to the hand, so
Perth
Bayswater have said, wind's not a problem for us. I suppose the scrum's a problem, so
I think it's a good option here by Bayzy to stay away from the scrum for a little bit. This victor on that scrum got real dominant, so let's see how they go on the line out. Dante Tatafu, throw. First throw there. Isaac Ryan releases to the back, Tavish Mead. Otu takes on Rory O'Sullivan and makes the gain.
10-20!
Strong carry there by Tavish Mead. Takes the ball right to the line. Like to see
that.
And a very good carry there by Nuku.
Now and
really big boot there by Aiden Shortall.
Says, we'll have another crack at the line out, pretty much at the same spot where they threw the last one. Dane, you can just see the speed that Isaac Lyons gives Perth Bayswater across the field. Like, when he wants to speed the game up and go, it's a huge threat, isn't it?
Absolutely, and having players running off him, the big ball carriers from Perth Bayswater will be key to them getting over the gain line and winning momentum. And then releasing this back line, he definitely has the skill and tackle options to score.
It's a little scrappy, but they bring it down.
Advantage!
Forward, and now they've got some penalty.
Not too sure what the advantage is for, but they've got an advantage. Free play here. Great offload. Aiden McDonough.
Lost forward, boys. No. Hey.
Aiden just words with each other there.
Hey. Well. Time off. Let's just have a word to number 13. We don't need that. I'll have a word to see. You have a word to him. Penalty. Offside.
I think he's got the back line there offside. Just breaking a bit early. UW are going to have to be careful there not to break too early off that line out. Good opportunity here for Otu. What does he do? I think he'll go for the line here. Their lineup was quite good before the first one. See if they can have a repeat.
And he squeezes that one over. As I said, low kick that one, but it's academic now. Perth Bayswater would have the line out. Last one's a little bit scrappy.
Yep.
broken play here. Isaac Fiennes loves this sort of play. Challenging the UW defensive line to help him strong.
No, no, seven entry in the side.
So I'd just like to see Basie just hold the ball there. Tavish Mead had a free play there with the advantage. Just keep the ball in hand and just see what you can do. See how you can challenge this UW backline.
You're playing with house money, aren't you? So, you know, why not have a crack? But again, the little chip with the wind, maybe they're just going.
Basie's defensive line is holding quite nicely. They're manning up around the fringes, which is quite good. They just need a stick in there.
Takes it up. Just rolling forward, just getting a few feet every time, and they've found themselves about 10 right now. Anderson it was, sorry. Well, fair few phases there from UWA. Did really well to secure the ball because Perth Bayswater were making it really difficult for them. Contesting every ruck, and once they realised it was on and they'd sucked enough of those defenders in, it was good hands out to the left-hand side, and as I said, Thomas Anderson still had a little bit to do. Had to put a little bit of a step on to get around that covered defender, but response from UWA after that Perth Bayswater penalty. 26 minutes gone here at UWA Sport Park, and UWA find themselves 2 points up with a pretty difficult kick, but wind at the back, so distance shouldn't be a problem for Caleb here.
We're just talking about that, mate. Yeah,
Basie were doing quite well holding around the fringes, but they just got sucked in and just failed to fold an extra player around the corner, and then it was just a simple one-on-one. And, yeah, Tom Anderson just beating the man one-on-one and going over in the corner. That's an outstanding kick there by Caleb Young.
In a masterclass, aren't we? That's ominous when he's kicking like that. It means you just can't afford to give away a penalty anywhere on the field. So UWA find themselves up 14-10. First Basie with the restart. Zach Oosthuizen takes it. set up for the box kick here. Right, it's a clearing kick from Caleb Young, and he just gets it off. It's a bit of a wobbly one, but it does find touch, but he was taken back. So that wind probably gave him an extra 10 metres there than he would have hoped for, and sets Perth Bayswater up nicely after that last rolling ball that we saw. Dane, you just dial it up again. You just say, boys, it worked for us last time.
Let's that's the middle.
Absolutely, I would be looking to go back to it. It was quite dominant. One thing that you wouldn't be happy about if you were a UW player and coach, another one off the kickoff. They've just scored a try. They couldn't get out of their own half, and Bayzy are back on attack. So,
well, they go short with the line out and try a different option. So they're taking it up now with Bayzy taking up the midfield now. They're 22.
Brandon Island with the carry there. Atu spreading it wide, attacking the wider channels, a bit upright and taking out of bounds. Just need to lower your height going on the fringes, maybe step back in. You want to keep that ball alive. And I think Bayzy would be a bit upset that they didn't put more pressure on UWA there.
They're beating the line though, aren't they? When the backs get it, they're getting past that gain line. It's just probably knowing when to go, right, let's take a phase, let's form a ruck and reset. But they are starting to bend the line a little bit for those UWA backs. It's a good line out there from UWA as they bring it down and set up a rolling ball, and they'll look to chip off a few metres for a potential exit. But Kake stumbles a little bit at the back, and they do get out of their 22. We'll see if we have a similar clearance as last time.
Just a carry up the midfield there by Jack Hardy, number 13.
Stripped out there by the number 10, but
and a downfield kick here by Rory O'Sullivan, well positioned by the fullback, taken really well there.
Yeah, we'll have a run at pace. Oh, throws a little dummy.
Andrew Ramsden returns it there over the halfway line. Isaac Fiennes looking for the ball, goes digging for it. Quite slow there for you for Bayzy.
I got nine.
On the blind side here, he's gonna have to work to stay in.
He does really well. Nathan Hardwick.
Come in, Rich.
Dante Tatafu, big carry up the middle, good footwork.
Strong UWA defense from the forwards.
Carry.
I didn't see that way at the start. Okay. Boys,
5-3, so still pretty even. But that's the first successful Jackal we've seen today, I think, because it's been very competitive at the breakdown. Both teams competing and committing a lot of numbers, really. So,
yeah, Charles Connolly, big tight end prop. He'll be talking to the back row, saying, "That's how you do it, boys." I'll go scrum, I'll pilfer, and you boys just hang out wide.
He knows his job, doesn't he?
There you go, with the five-man lineup.
Two not straight for UWA now, and one for Perth Bayzy. So
the Bayzy go back to the lineup. They are staying away from those scrums, Jace. They don't want to go back to them. So even despite the wind, they are in lineup option. So see how Dante goes. Struggling a little bit in the lineup, Bayzy. UWA back on attack. Forced a one hit. Shifting it out wide to Jack Hardy. Jack beats it first man. Great run.
Go left again. They've got numbers here if they run through the hands, but Bayswater have scrambled in defence well, and UWA have said an off big shot there, and they're pushed back. None of these players want to leave there today. It's all on the line. Do or die rugby is UWA setting up about 20 out. Dart from the first row, and then he goes back to the left. Pick and go gets the arm out.
So it was a good turnover there by Ada McDonough, but they come back for a previous infringement. Just trying to see what Sam is calling there. Offside. It's quite a kickable penalty here for Caleb Young, and he does indeed point toward the post. So really good play there, very composed by UWA. They just look to hold onto the ball and play phase after phase, and evidently that wore down Basie and they gave away the penalty.
Yeah, great little dart there by Jack Hardy, ripped off a little bit of a line break there, and as I said, got Perth Basie would move backwards, which a couple more phases led to the penalty. So UWA have an opportunity here to put it out to a converted try if Caleb Young's successful here in the way he's been kicking the footy, apart from that first one, which was probably the easiest one of all. He's accounted for the wind, and you wouldn't bet against him. Successfully kicks it through, pretty straightforward when he's on that kind of form, and WA move out to 7 points. Thank, great to see a couple of the ball kids here. We had our junior semi-finals down in
six Manchester to go, Paisley.
Loads of rugby down there. Heard it was a fantastic day. Great this year. The Grandy at Wanneroo is a combination of the junior and senior final back together, so it's going to be a huge festival of rugby at Wanneroo, Kingsway Sporting Complex, and celebrating all things rugby, Wanneroo's 50th anniversary, and just can't wait till next week, really. But we've still got some footy to play here, so UWA receive the kickoff. Or restart, I should say, and Kake takes it up. One phase as they set off the exit now, here with Young.
Young wants to adjust for the wind. He's kicked it down the field this time, near the sideline. Great take there by Andrew Ramsden. Beats Rory O'Sullivan, carries well back over the halfway line.
He's looking dangerous when he gets the ball off those kick returns, so hopefully we can see a bit more of that. He's happy to have a dart, certainly down this near side.
Brandon Marlow there with the carry on halfway line. Rory O'Sullivan shoots out the line. That's very dangerous because Isaac Fiennes will spot the gap, but he makes up for it with an intercept there. Just an offload intercepted by Rory O'Sullivan.
And a penalty.
Just gone off his feet there by the signal. Not hold right there, the tight end prop, Sam Fargali.
And if there's anybody watching this on YouTube that can bring a couple of hot chocolates to the commentary team, if you're with us to UWA Sport Park, because that wind is pretty chilly. Colleague Dane's shivering a bit here, so hopefully we can get some hot chocolates at half time. And the players won't be bothered by it though, they're red hot out there and giving it a good crack. Straight and
it's the early lift.
The early lift, and that's the right call there. Sammy's on top of his game. The UWA
jump.
Support here, just letting Sam know that he's made the right decision there as well. Very supportive, and UWA has said it's been a while since we've had a scrum, and we liked how that was going. So let's have another crack at it. Do you think they'll be in a rush to get the ball out the back of this scrum if you're UWA, or do you think you'll put it in there and say, let's see what you've got for Bayswater?
Yeah, I'd be holding it in there, letting the tight five do their thing, because let's be honest, the back row don't do anything. So the five up front, they'll be pushing the hardest. Let's see if UWA get the upper hand. Bayswater, good to...
A little bit of early movement there, I think. It wasn't quite stable when UWA looked to be a little bit of a shove on early, so Sam might just be saying, settle down, guys. We know you want to scrum. You fancy it, but you've got to wait until the ball's in.
One of the best sights at a scrum when it goes down like that is that neither prop has done anything wrong. It's always the other man taking it down. both props there signalling to Graham Cooper, the assistant referee on the near side, just that the opposite prop was dropping his bind. But here we are, we said again. Just another delay on the scrum.
So I've got 38 minutes online, so 2 minutes to go, and UWA would be looking at any opportunity to push it out beyond 7 points going into half time. They'll probably feel pretty good about themselves, the way things are going, but Perth Bayswater are definitely in this. And what's your call on that one, Dave?
No, that was an assistant referee call, Graham Cooper. You got on there, the tight end prop there, Charles Connolly, just dropped his bind a little bit long. Needs to get his feet up and just to help him be a bit more stable at the breakdown. So a really good call.
So lucky to have an international referee AR-ing for us in this game. That's the kind of support you get on, and those on-field calls. So
middle.
That's a big win for Perth Bayswater.
Middle boys.
That's the first scrum victory they've got.
Great throw there by Dante. Well taken. Tavish Mead releases it to Otu.
Oh, happy there, Ian. Number 7 off feet. Stay up.
They just got caught going off their feet there, trying to
number
seal it.
Number 7 off feet.
Number 7, Aidan McDonough. Seconds. Didn't support his body weight. UWA did get the dominant tackle there, pushed him back, tried to kind of ruck, and Aidan just sealed it off, trying to secure it for his team. And Sam Jones picked it up, penalised him, and UWA on halfway with the penalty.
Last play here.
It's great work, UWA. Sam? As soon as they sense the turnover, they piled everyone in there. And that hasn't found touch.
Yep.
Bayswater say, let's get back in the sheds. Good half footy.
Great half of footy there, Jason. And I think at 17 points to 10, I think it's a fair indication of how the game's gone. UWA being quite dominant, just start early. Again, their big talk at halftime should be about securing ball after they score a try, because that led Bayzy back into the game twice. And Bayzy, I think if they just get a bit of a pill, hold on to it, they're bending the line, as you mentioned earlier. So I think we're in here for a cracker second half.
I couldn't agree. Well, look forward to you joining us for the second half. We're going to take a break here and try and warm up, and hopefully we'll see you back here in 6 or 7 minutes' time for the second half. Probably 5 if we're timing it correctly.
We probably should know that.
Probably dial in 5, not 6 or 7. But no, it's been a great first half, and as I said, do or die rugby. We'll see you back here in a bit.
Chase line there. Aiden Shortall now with the return. Gets over the halfway line. Good go forward ball. Brendan Forster releases. Victor Harris. Yeah, just tuck it and carry, Victor.
He's had some really good carries today. And we're looking to get a few more. Kakake here. Takes it up. One off the rock.
Leave it though!
Good. Do you have a UWA player down in back play receiving treatment, which leaves it a bit short-handed, but...
Does look like their captain, Jack Bromley. Looking like a knee, but we'll keep posted on that.
Good steal first!
Sullivan takes it up to the line. And, oh, and there's a steal there, and Perth Bayswater gets the pass off the line break now, and Perth Bayswater look to go left, and it's been knocked forward by Perth Bayswater. UWA come away with it now.
Nuku there just thought the ball was out, and Sam Jones thought otherwise, so penalised for offside.
So what's the chat that Sam's having here, Dane? If it, unfortunately, with the mics being this windy, we're not going to hear it. Do you think he's just saying we made it 9-4 in the penalty count, or?
Yeah, I think it's just we're just going to have a bit of a stoppage here. Basie haven't been terrible all game. Not you said 9-4 in the penalty count. I think they've been a bit unlucky a couple times there. Just probably inaccurate at the breakdown rather than ill-disciplined, if that makes any sense. But I think here with Jack Bromley just getting some treatment, the captain of UWA, just to slow it down a little bit.
He was on the ground for a long time there, but it looks like he's gonna try and fire it on.
I think they might have got the magic spray again.
I've got a hot take for you again from one of our colleagues, some razor sharp analysis, that the other semi-final, it's all West Scarborough. They're up 30-7 over at Bennett Park, and apparently their forwards have been absolutely dominant, and Nevin sort of got a try just before the break. They're a little bit ahead of us there, so yeah, if you're watching the stand game, switch on over to this one, because 30-7, it sounds like it's going all West way. Referees have sorted it out, and UWA will have the line out just past 10 metres into their own half. Let's see what they can do. Oh, well contested by Perth Bayswater, but even better takedown from UWA on the second try here. Rory O'Sullivan goes now. Slip tackle here. And Jack Hardy has come back from many injuries, and he's made some really strong carries today.
Yeah, Sam George is just getting beaten one-on-one there. A great turnover by Sam, as I mentioned his name, at the breakdown. Otu releasing Isaac Fiennes one-on-one with the number two. This is dangerous.
Here we go, Perth Bayswater. pass out wide. Oh, the winger. He's put it down and...
Option.
Yep. Eyes off the ball.
Scrum only.
I think he was looking. I mean, there's a lot of hands in the way. It wasn't the easiest take in this win. But Perth Bayswater, they'll be gutted there. They great opportunity. I mean, just give Isaac Fiennes the ball in broken play and let him work his magic. And there'll be a few UWA defenders there that are probably breathing a few sighs of relief because that's not what you want to do.
Definitely not. If I see him coming, I'm definitely pulled a hammy, mate. I'm not chasing him. He is electric. And good play there by Otto to swat him early, release him. He beats the number two and then just makes that play upfield. Unlucky there, Nathan Hardwick just couldn't reel that in because I think, yeah, could be the meat pie there in the corner.
They're definitely in this game, Perth Basie, but they actually got the last scrum penalty for the half. So if they can get something here, they, ooh, that's folded in a little bit, but UWA come away with it.
And a great run there by Clay Ewan getting well over the gain line.
Good clear.
Yes!
Advantage. No!
Baby, yeah, just again ill-disciplined here. Ill-disciplined at the breakdown, coming in from the side.
Number six in the side.
Number six there. I think that goes to Matt Gully. In from the side. And Sam spots it.
Coops? You good?
Yeah. About changing anything from a Perth Bayswater point of view, would you say, no, we've got the ball, we're getting out of the wider channels, we're looking dangerous, let's just stay the course and maybe just clear up some of those penalties, 10 feet, and that's...
Oh, Nathan Hardwick there, gee whiz, he would be absolutely at himself there. Kick didn't find touch by Caleb Young and Nathan has knocked it on. And they had a good attacking opportunity there, released it to Isaac Fiennes, and who knows what could have happened. So UWA get out of jail free card there. They might have played it a bit early. They have a scrum upfield now, right in front of the Basie bench. I'm sure the Basie guys will assist Sam here if anything goes wrong in the scrum.
Oh, it's always handy having a couple of extra referees on the bench so close to the scrum.
UWA get to work here. They actually get through the mark, and yes, there's the advantage. Let's see what they do here with the free play. We come back for the penalty. Great scrum yet again. Victor Harris getting the upper hand on
straight.
His opposite number, Sam.
You'd want to keep him on for the full 80 the way he's playing, Dane. You wouldn't want to move to clubs. They might just keep packing down those scrums because that's where UWA are getting a bit of leaves that one a little shorter than the last one.
Not Dane Swear, they push through the mark.
See the likes of Jack Hardy having a bit of a strike play at 13 here. And
look to get it to Jack pretty quick and release him and let him have a one-on-one with his opposite man.
Oh, hit while he was passing.
There we go, Jack.
Line. Here is Jack, tries to get to the outside and Otto's over that one and he might...
Oh, leave!
It's a close one, but UWA retain the ball and they roll around here on the short side.
That's good.
Out to the captain, a little pop pass, but there's no one running onto it, and UWA going a little bit backwards now. And
let it go, boys!
Having a chat about what they're going to do later. Clay Ewan.
Still some rugby to be played here. Clay Ewan, this is the first tackle, holds on, pops it out wide to Trottle, and he plays it down.
Good offload. Clay Ewan with the second touch there in the play. Rory O'Sullivan taking that forward. Here goes Victor.
He's a big fella. Look at that. Oh, bumps off one. Get out of the way. And pick and drive here by UWA.
Take it in. Sorry.
Jesus, a little bit messy at the breakdown. Quick hands now. And it is going to be a penalty. I think that call might have come from the AR. Yeah, just taking out the man beyond the ball. And Isaac Fine, he thinks he's off with a quick tap here, but the referee's said, let's just calm things down here, guys. It's getting a bit silly.
Boys just putting on a bit of extra rugby there for the fans. That was obviously when time was off. Sam calling them back.
Boys, back. You got to get. Over that, please.
I need you to get him over there. On the ruck, it was came charging in, and I think he did the old matador. Pulled the flag on him, and he's gone past the ruck.
I'm just not handbag there. I've got nothing in particular.
No, I think you got all the chance.
Yep.
What
yep.
time do you have?
48:30. Bit of noise coming from the hill now, and everyone getting into this one. It's a competitive game. What sound does a numbat make, Dane?
Not too sure. But
I'm hearing some numbats over on the left there. They're getting into it now, and
great support here by Perth Bayswater. Getting out in big numbers to support their team, their club. And great to see them here in the semi-final here in 2022. They're not out of it, Jason. They've got everything to play for. A few more phases, ball in hand, and they can do anything from anywhere.
Yeah, I see what you mean. They're very low, but from my perspective, they're legal.
Few areas now.
I think they're legal. Okay, so have a chat there.
Crowd favourite, getting the crowd into it and saying, come on, guys, get behind us.
Yep, I agree. Yep.
This one, but we've been having a chat for a fair while now, so
yeah, the boys will be getting cold.
Yeah, we get to play some rugby.
They're low, but they're okay. I understand. Yeah.
Refereeing by committee here, but we're going to play some rugby now, so that's
there
good.
Go. Bit of an obstruction there. That's what the penalty is for, Jace.
Okay, I must have made just something missed that. Up that. Well, Ian missed it, but there was that going beyond the ruck as well, so.
And a great kick there by Otu, taking play up over halfway. Hazy with the line out right in front of us here, Jason. Time off. A bit of a replacement. He's going off.
Number three.
I've got Sam heading off. Oh no. And, number one, Yona, according to my team sheet. Replaced by number 17, Nico.
Here we go, Perth Bayswater secure the ball from the line out. Let's have a crack. A bit of a wobbly old pass, but Otu takes it up there. Just inside their own half, middle of the field. Isaac Fine pops the ball out wide left. Perth Bayswater through the hands and 5 or so metres. This is where they look dangerous, Dame. We want to see him running with ball in hand and just being a little bit wider in their play than the other way.
Probably not the option that Bayzy were looking at. Ball in hand is the option.
Oh, mate, safe as houses there. Look at that. Here we go. Hooker out in the open and gets past the game line. So Perth Bayswater pretty much back where they started. Fresh off the bench now.
Nico Fargali.
Yeah, he's going to have a little bit of a run, so I want in on the action.
Tavish Mead taking the ball to the line. Love it when a 10 carries. Keeps the defence honest. Isaac Fines trying to search for that ball. It's a bit slow. Otu puts it on the boot. Plugs the corner. Well positioned by Aiden Shorter, and he'll put it back downfield with a bit of extra oomph.
Backwards. Right call there, but the nerds on the hill give him a bit of a cheer and let him know they're watching the game, and it looks as though it's ripped down the tackle. UWA have it here, and they're breaking away with it now, and it's Borster. He's going to be taken into touch by Perth Bayswater, but oh geez, it looks really dangerous there off the a little bit scrappy for Perth Bayswater, and UWA pounce, heads up play by Worcester. And UWA will say to Perth Bayswater, let's see you exit year 22 in this wind.
Yeah, and I think Jace, we spoke about it a few times now that on attack they're bending the line, Perth Bayswater, but twice now they look good and then just put the ball on the boot, and both of them weren't great kicks. and they turned over. Another short throw, underthrown there by Dante. Victor Harris gets his hands on the ball yet again. He's been everywhere today.
Hey, two!
That loose head.
Not on it.
Come on!
You've got to think Victor Harris is he's got to be up on the list there. He's had so many
advantage!
The other hook, hooker, Charles Connolly, actually, with that carry, and he's won on the penalty.
I think Jack Hardy's been quite good as well. Really helped UW get on the front foot.
It's happy. He's put himself in that position.
Because the UWA fans are starting to get pretty vocal. I like the way things are going now. And
Caleb Young, we saw him down kicking yesterday, practicing on this field. So this one should just be a walk in the park.
Did he miss any, Dave? Did you see?
Not that I saw. He missed many. So I think he was just dialing in the radar. But this one should be an easy one for him. Right in front of, or just to the left of the sticks here, Chase. And I'm sure UWA will extend their lead.
UWA a bit of breathing room as well. 20-10 here at UWA Sport Park. As we're in the second half of the Fortescue Rugby WA 2022 semi-final. Big dance next weekend. Can't wait. But Perth Bayswater, they've got a bit of work to do now. Might need to push things to find them. So there's plenty of time left in this one. And they go high with the restart. And referee Ian Sunderland is saying,
I think Victor might have just gave him a bit of odd, but it didn't touch his head.
If you didn't see that, I got it. I'll tell you, hit the line. So go for a scrum restart, which is probably not what Perth Bayswater wants about now, the old scrum restart. But they've got a new front row, so let's see if they can have an impact on the game and how this set piece has been going.
Like number 21 from Bayswater, Joe Anun, is on the field as well. Just trying to see who he's replaced. It looks like number 6, Matt Fo'agali.
Another big shove coming through from UWA, and it kind of splinters and turns, and the referee says that wasn't really going forward. I think I agree with that call, and a little bit of afters between Isaac Fines and Oosthuizen. Caleb Young, it's something that tasty out there today, and then Perth Bayswater are saying, come on. Any changes for UWA, Dave? I've been paying attention.
I haven't seen any just yet, Jace. I think they've stuck with their starting 15. That's done them the good so far. Up 20 points.
Boy, that's just
I think you'd give them a little bit longer, see how they go. Well, and looking at the scrum.
It's still dominant, isn't it?
Like, very much so.
There's fuel in the tank for those guys, so they...
Victor Harris loves scrummaging. If you chat to him, it's just, when can we scrum? So we go again, reset. One win, 90 degrees.
Worcester with the feed, UWA get the shove on. And the second little momentum goes forward here for UWA, and they do earn the penalty. And now Isaac Fine just sort of comes in there and says, well, I'm not going to let you have a play at that.
Not bad play there. It was, you would assume here that UW will go for a line-out and put pressure on their line-out. They haven't had a great day throwing in, so I think that was a good option by Isaac Pines to kill the ball and go to a set piece. Looks like another change here for Perth Bayswater. We'll just get the number 7. Aidan McDonough is heading off the field.
Hey, he's on this, all good.
Kakaki to throw in for UWA, and the wind has really picked up now as well, so we'll see how he goes. It comes off the fingertips, and yeah, commentator's curse there. It's fighting a pretty stiff breeze there.
Yeah, I think they've struggled all day to have a throw into the lineup, so they may be looking to, they may have to rethink what they do at the penalties, Jason. You know, another scrum option might be the way to go. Looks like Kieran Westlake is coming on now for UWA, number 20. And off goes big number 8, Zach Gustafson. What a name.
Yeah, enjoyed saying it. It's a shame to see him go. He's had a good game. A couple of carries.
Go, Victor, go!
Oh, Victor, he saw the line.
Number 1.
He is everywhere, that man. Good pressure there by UWA at the lineout. Dante's having a bit of trouble hitting his man. They may need to shorten the lineup, maybe go a 3-man option. And just,
I mean, does it take it? Is it a consideration here that UWA go, okay, we've knocked on, but guess what? We get to pack another scrum. And the way things are going, I've got 13-4 on the penalty count. It's pretty hard to win a game of rugby when you're that far. So Perth Bays would need to do something here to try and even that penalty count now. And a big shove again from the UWA scrum going backwards, but Isaac Fine gets it out. Otu now clearance kick. It's semi-charged down there by Caleb Young, and we'll take out the and here we go, Perth Bayswater. Was there a tackle before he got the ball there? It's knocked on by UWA, so Perth Bayswater get to play with house money here. Wesley makes the tackle and rolls away. Otu in a scrum.
Advantage!
Fly half, I should say. Get my words out, and here we go.
Isaac Fines, he
wants
to
go quick, and I think that's the
right
option now.
Good.
Takes a quick tap, has a little dart, pops it outside.
Advantage,
good.
They've dropped it cold, about 10 out. It was a great opportunity for Perth Bayswater.
Jacob Buis just knocking it on there. Good D on the fringes there by Dante Tatafu. Making UWA work hard there to clear it. Looks like it's going to go back to Caleb Young. Caleb Young puts it on the boot. He finds touch just outside the 22. Bayzy still on attack here.
No, a good result for UWA, but they've just shown that you can't go to sleep when you've got Isaac Fines and some of these players from Perth Bayswater like Otu. That's way back in from now. Starting to speed up the game.
Absolutely, and I think that's where the broken play is what's going to be Bayzy's friend. They don't want to go to set piece and have a slow ball, so Isaac will be looking to speed things up, and I think bringing
time on,
boys! Actually, I think it's Fa'amanu. Fa'amanu's come onto the field in number 20 for Bayzy, so this is going to help Bayzy coming into the back end of the second half. He's a great player, old Manu. Really hard on the ball, strong carrier, will work well off Isaac.
No idea.
Straight the other way, straight to Perth Bayswater.
Well, I think it was Bayzy's ball there, so yeah. I think Bayzy and Yuda both struggling in the line out there, so both hookers not having the best day.
Commentators struggling to see that as well, because there's so many people here on the UWA hill. See some of the kids playing and getting into their rugby.
Yep.
Can't wait to see the junior grand final next Saturday in the morning, and then followed by the senior grand final. We had reserve grade on the field before this game.
58, 59 minutes.
Palmyra reserve grade winning it.
You happy with that?
Death with a try in the corner. The hill went absolutely berserk, and the Palms will have a team in the grand final. And then the Seagulls, last year's winners of the women's competition. Again, that was a great final last year with a try to death. They were a bit more dominant today over the Wanneroo Divas, but it was a good competitive game. As I said, fantastic refereeing for all those budding referees. That was one to watch.
He was good.
But
just heard. I've heard a few things that he was good. So good on him. Good on whoever that ref was. I'm sure he will be looking to get a finals. The grand final. I'm sure they'll put him in.
UWA get the scrum and looking to maintain that dominance. initially. UW doesn't get that second shove on, and they fall out. Rory O'Sullivan here now goes to Jack Hardy. Big strong carry, takes two to tackle him. Down to the way there. Set up for a kick. Rory puts a high one on it. It's blowing around in the wind. You can see Isaac finds readjusting there, and he puts a big fend on Rory O'Sullivan, and then chips a little grubber over the top. And has that touched a UWA hand? No, it hasn't.
And I think
kick there, but it's probably a bit more depth on that. But
I think he was looking for that 50-22, would have given them the ball back. But here they are at the lineout where UWA has struggled today. They get it to their captain, reliable Jack Bromley. Kieran Westlake carry in the middle. Again, takes two to take him down. They'll be looking to clear. Caleb Young back in the pocket. Straight down the middle of the park. Into the breeze.
Oh, it's taken a mean bounce. And a really good chase here. And Kukake, the UWA forward, managed to win a penalty there for Perth Bayswater. He heads up play. Once Kukake went down to pick up the ball, he's jumped over for the pilfer. And it's a pretty short angle here for number 12 or 2 for Perth Bayswater, but we'll be hoping to send him a bit further down the field. He's been kicking well so far today.
I think that breeze is really favouring Perth Bayswater now. Jason is coming in right behind their back, so UWA are going to have to work it out of their heart through the hand rather than just their kick downfield. We can see play territory has been in the UW half.
Another change by Perth Bayswater at the hooker position.
Straight throwing.
There you go. Throw a line out straight. No pressure, mate.
Next 10, let's go. Let's go.
Advantage in the air.
Taken in the air. Arm out. Perth Bayswater playing with house money. That goes through the backs.
It's a bit far behind the gain line there. Manu with the carry.
Advantage.
Another advantage there.
I'm a yellow there, mate.
Tavish Mead deep in the pocket. Chip kick. Ben Buist on the wing.
Same thing.
Get a double tap on the whistle.
Oh, he's going to the pocket.
Oh, hang on a second. Hold the phone.
18.
Bayswater are going to have a man advantage for 10 minutes.
I think Reggie Churchwood there maybe gave away a cynical penalty. And Sam Jones gave the yellow.
Well, he didn't hesitate, did he? So he had a pretty clear view of that one.
And again, with the wind behind their back, distance won't be an issue here for Otu.
Is he signaled for the 3 points he has? So yeah. It's
mate, always upright. It's foul play.
Exciting finish with Perth Bayswater, a man up for 10 minutes of this one. Might just go a little bit past that, and then it'll be full time. So they've got to make a move now, starting here with Otu.
Just for those watching, that if this goes to extra time, we'll have a quick changeover, two periods of 10 minutes to decide the winner. Let's hope we get it. I want more rugby.
Oh, dude, another hot chocolate, not ready to go for another hour, I reckon.
I must have missed that order. Kicks up. It looks a bit wide to the right.
To the right, so
22 dropout here to UW. They're a man down for the next 10 minutes, so we'll see how they adjust their attacking play. Losing big Reginald Churchwood. big ball carrier. He's done well today. Could be a tactical 10-minute break.
Yeah, maybe just sort of, look, I want to come back on, but I could use a 10-minute breather. So.
Yeah.
Caleb Young kicks it off into the wind, so it comes out to about halfway. Isaac finds they were starting to make ground. That's the last thing you want, and he filthied himself there. It's pretty much go time for Bayesy now, I think.
So we'll see how UWA adjust to the seven-man scrum, losing Reggie, as we mentioned, for the yellow card. Looked like a cynical penalty, so I'm sure this tight five will still hold strong. Kieran Westlake will slide forward from eighth man into lock. Surely Bayesy will be looking to attack now at the scrum, trying to get a penalty. Good scrum by UWA.
Excellent effort for a seven-man scrum. And Rory O'Sullivan, kind of unorthodox kind of handling error there, and deemed to have gone forward. It was sort of a bit of a basketball or netball pass there as he fumbled it, but so we'll have another scrum and we'll get the feed this time. Dane, if you've got nothing to do next Saturday, head on down to, well, head on up to Kingsway Regional Sporting Complex for the Festival of Rugby that'll be the grand final day. It's rugby from ear to ear, 8 o'clock in the morning till the big grandy at Premier Grade, 5 p.m. 30 finish.
Somewhere out there.
Forgotten how to talk, but
13 games of rugby, Jace.
Oh, it's, I can't wait. It's
beautiful.
It's going to be good, and there's obviously going to be food trucks and help yourself to a beverage. And despite having seven men in the scrum, UWA has asserted their dominance and continued the trend of this game, really. And it's hard to see how Perth Bayswater are going to ride this ship now. And then it's not done. They can get back into it, but it's been a bit.
17 collapsing.
Yep.
He's got to get his own ball.
So 17 there, just been told by Sam that he was collapsing. Needs to get his arm up, get the bind up. All budding front rowers need to get their bind up, make a clear picture for the referee.
I think he's setting up good. Yeah.
Impressively the same front row as well, isn't it? Yeah. They haven't made the changes yet. Kake had the throw here for.
Now off his neck! Good.
Going sideways. Forster says, I'll have a crack.
Yeah, probably the first carry I've seen him today. I haven't seen him much involved. They've gone back down the blind. Victor Harris met in a good hit, but still goes forward.
No, it's ready!
Manu's just been called out of it. Kieran Westlake diving for a pass. Good slip take. Clay Ewan coming in for some work off the wing. UWA just slowing it down now. Kieran Westlake going into nine. Pick and carry. Gets met very firmly there.
Power! Get up! Use it!
Just saying, keep going.
UWA backs are very narrow here. They're all within the 35 metres of the field. Throw a blanket over the UW team. Spread out. I think they're working for a penalty here. Jason staying up the middle of the field.
Because 10 points is still doable, but if it gets any out further than that, it'll be a tall order. UWA happy. They might have a little bit of a strike play here now with the backs as Rory O'Sullivan gets it. And again, a little bit of a juggle.
Jack Hardy, probably the 10th carry.
Hey, off now!
Done really well. Getting
he had a good shot.
Most times, so really good work by Jack. Slow to get up there, Jack, but UWA just composed themselves. Well up in double digits here in phases. Here in Westlake, another pick and go from the base.
Good.
Bazy, very good discipline. Wait, line.
Huge nine.
Away the penalties here, Bazy.
Also has a bit of a dart.
And he's through.
He's broken through. Isaac Fox grabs it, but he gets over the line. And early Bayswater come up with a great little dart from Vorse to the nine. He's been good today as well. And good heads up play. Perth Bayswater having to commit so many at the breakdown there with that UWA one out. A couple of phases coming around the mall, sucking him in. And then Forster heads up play there.
Just a bit of a mismatch there. Forster seeing the bit of the forwards up front. And he backed himself. Got caught by the jersey there by Isaac Fines, but too strong. Got over the line. Takes the lead, 25 points to 10 with the kick to come here by Caleb Young. I think there with a man down. Very, very composed rugby there by UWA.
I think they managed the game
where
well,
you are.
Haven't they, as well? And it's, they've done it all season. I mean, they're minor premiers for a reason. And they sewed up the minor premiership with about two rounds to go, I think, so. The Rugby WA Cup as well, secured that off Soaks with a few rounds to go and then defended it at home. So obviously if this kick goes over, they'll feel pretty confident that they're going to contest the Grandy at Kingsway, and they'll have a crack at all three major trophies, the minor, the major and the Rugby WA Cup. They've sealed up two of them. Conversion successful. That puts Uni out by 17 points, 27 to 10. Might have to be a bit more descriptive in our commentary because we've heard there's some little bit of crackly footage coming through. So, but I can tell you, can't see it on the screen at the moment. It's all green now at UWA. It was competitive first half.